All right, so who are you and what do you do?
I am Lord Malachi. I govern them. My name is Jabril Ash. I produce a science show, or education. It's education called SCFP Science. And that's what I do. I also edit for Diana, the physics girl at the moment. I really love that gig. Diana's awesome.
Cool.
Join myself.
Nice. So why do you do science?
Why do I do science? The reason why I do science, that's really a question. For me to answer that question, I think I need to really dive deep into why do I like science, you know? Because I'm not so much doing science, I'm doing what is natural for me. And I have a really deep interest in science and like just the future of things, the origins of things, the whole entire gamut of everything.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm not entirely sure why I like that. I've never really thought about that, to be honest with you. Something in my childhood, I'm sure, though.
Yeah.
I'll get back to you on this question like next year or something. I'll think about it.
All right. Yeah. So since you're doing science and you like doing science, why do you do it on YouTube?
So the reason why I do it on YouTube, oh, I'm sorry, do you want me to do the question? Okay. Well, the reason why I do science on YouTube is obviously because it's a platform that's completely free,
mm-hmm.
right? There, at no point do I have to go to Lionhead Studios or whatever and say, hey guys, I need a budget of $5,000 because here's what I have in mind. And they can be like, I like it, but take away this character here and put it in. Like, I don't have to deal with any of that, you know? It's just like, whatever I'm able to do, I can do it and put up on the internet. And what's also special about the ability of the individual is also, if you're curious enough, that ability is limitless. You can do anything.
Mm-hmm.
When I started making videos in 2010 out of high school, I didn't know anything about video editing.
Mm-hmm.
It was just natural curiosity that made me learn, you know, how do I do visual effects? How do I create 3D models and make them render? And how do I add that to videos? Like, what's the most effective way to edit audio? So that's the reason why I do YouTube. It's just because I have complete control of everything.
Nice. So you mentioned that you you do editing for Diana. How did you get set up with that?
So the way that I joined Diana's team, Physics Girl, I had started my educational channel last year, around September or so, and I just reached out to a bunch of people within the space, just let them know, like, hey guys, like, I'm trying this out, I really like education, science, and whatnot, and if you need any help, please let me know, I'll be willing to help you out.
Mm-hmm.
And we both live in the same city, and honestly, I'll be completely honest, it was all just timing. She had just got rid of her old editor, and she's like, I'm looking mm-hmm. for someone new. I'm glad you reached out. Would you like to do this?
Mm-hmm.
She offered it on the table, and I was like, yeah, I mean, why not? You know, so. And I'm really grateful for that because, like, she has her bachelor's in physics, and, like, physics is a very complicated topic.
Yeah.
And sometimes while editing, I'm very confused. However, like, she's always there, so I ask her, hey, what exactly are you looking for here? And I learned a lot from editing with her, and, like, I meet a lot of cool people and get to do a lot of cool things, and I'm really grateful for that opportunity.
Very cool. So one of the cool things that you have mentioned, so you have your own channel.
Correct.
And you also work with Diana.
Correct.
When you have questions for your own channel, do you use her as a resource, like, you know, hey, Diana, I don't understand this thing, can you help me understand it?
Yeah, for sure. I do that as much as I possibly can. She's also a very busy lady.
Yeah.
She's always like out of town and doing conferences and all this other stuff. So she's not always available, but when she is available, like I have a video coming out soon about mirrors.
Mm-hmm.
Just a quick overview on my channel. Like I often start off with very basic questions, you know, stuff that just like an average person in the everyday will probably like ponder on. Like, for example, this video is, what is a mirror?
Yeah.
You know, for example, like, you look at a mirror every single day, but what is it? You know, it's mm-hmm. not a material. You can't go into a forest and get mm-hmm. mirror material. So, for example, that video is coming up, and she's helping me out with just understanding the physics of, like, you know, glass and how certain wavelengths go through glass, but not all wavelengths go through, and she's helping me understand all that stuff. So, hope that answers the question.
Nice. Going forward, do you have any goals for either your channel or for Physics Girl or just for YouTube in general?
What a load of questions. Yeah, of course. The thing about goals, specifically for YouTube, is it's always more fun. I'm not entirely sure what type of like time scale that the morph occurs, but it definitely is always morphing. I remember when I first started, I had a totally different goal of what I have now, and it's all just part of the experience, you know. Like you come to a convention like this, and you meet people like you who provide a different perspective, and other people who provide different perspectives, and it changes your perspective on things. But to answer it simply, yeah, my goal is just to provide a show in which is a cool place for anyone to go, no matter what your level of understanding of anything is. Mm-hmm. You can be guaranteed that whatever the question is that you click on, you will get that answer and more without any extra work from you. Like, you don't have to go to Google and search out extra keywords, and I'll take care of all that for you.
Nice.
So I guess that's kind of my goal.
Sweet, yeah. So, final questions. If you had, like, if somebody asked you for just general advice in terms of getting started on YouTube or even going into science as a thing,
okay.
What would you tell them?
So there are a few different approaches that I can go here. I'm just trying to think what's the most optimal one to go with. Okay, I think I'm going to say just this one's because it probably covers more people.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to say start with the most bare minimum equipment possible. Because I take it that most people's passion isn't going to be to the production side of things. Fortunately for me, I have a great passion for production. That's my favorite part, editing. Anyhow, start with the most bare minimum equipment. Mm-hmm. I'm talking like cell phone, you know. Yeah. Shoot a video or two with that, upload it, mm-hmm. right? And after you upload it, rewatch it, and then you'll start to pick apart parts you don't like. Like, mm-hmm. maybe the resolution isn't good enough, or yep. maybe you want to do better audio.
Mm-hmm.
And then it's that, once you realize those errors and mistakes, that's when you'll learn what you need to upgrade versus like trying to spend $2,000 on the 70D and like all this equipment and whatnot and not knowing how to use it.
Yeah,
that's probably my best advice. Focus on the reason why you started the channel and start mm-hmm. the bare minimum equipment and just upgrade as you need to.
Very cool. And now, real final question. Do you have a sign-off?
A sign-off. Remember to always feed your curiosity. It's important.
All right. Hey, thanks so much. I'll talk to you later.
Thank you so much. I had a lot of fun.